On the 26th of January 2000, the Pyrenean Ibex went extinct when the very last individual was struck by a fallen tree and died. However, 3 years later, the Pyrenean Ibex was declared extinct once again. Unlike other animals, the Ibex went extinct twice. This was possible because on the 30th of July 2003, a team of Spanish and French scientists successfully brought back the Pyrenean Ibex from extinction through cloning. The clone individual was born alive, but only survived for several minutes before dying from a lung defect and plunging its species into extinction for the second time. The Pyrenean Ibex was one of four subspecies of the Iberian Ibex. One subspecies, the Portuguese Ibex, disappeared in 1892 after being continuously hunted by humans. Pyrenean Ibex were common and abundant in the Middle Ages. They inhabited the Pyrenees of Andorra, southern France, and likely extended into the Cantabrian Mountains in Spain. Its population began to decline in the 18th century due to hunting pressure. Competition over grazing area with human-introduced animals like sheep, domestic goats, cattle, and horses has also contributed to its extinction. The last Pyrenean Ibex was a female named Celia. She was determined to be the only one left in the world in 1999 and was tagged with a radio collar. Unfortunately, just 9 months later, Celia was found dead by rangers at a Spanish national park, crushed by a fallen tree. But before that, she'd had her skin biopsies from her ear harvested and cryopreserved, which would later be used as the source of the genetic material to clone her. On the 8th of October 2000, the government of Spain gave permission to an American biotechnology company, Advanced Cell Technology, to use Celia's frozen tissue in a joint effort with Spanish and French government institutions to clone the Pyrenean Ibex. They used Spanish Ibex and hybrid goats, a mix between a Spanish Ibex and a domestic goat, as surrogate mothers and source of egg donor. They were chosen for their similar gestation period. Over the course of two experiments, a total of 782 clone embryos were reconstituted, and the chosen 208 were transferred to either the Spanish Ibex or the hybrid goat recipients. But most of the recipients failed to become pregnant, and 6 out of the only 7 successful pregnancies terminated spontaneously before day 75. Only in one hybrid goat did the pregnancy continue normally until term. At 162 days of pregnancy, on the 30th of July 2003, a cesarean section was performed on the surrogate mother, and a female Pyrenean Ibex baby was obtained alive, genetically identical to Celia. An exact clone of the last individual of a subspecies that went extinct 3 years prior. The kid's weight was a normal 2.6 kilograms, with no external morphological abnormalities and showed a normal cardiac rhythm. However, she suffered from severe respiratory distress after delivery and died a few minutes later. Further examination found that the kid had a non-functional additional lobe in the left lung, but had no other pathological alterations found in her organs. It is not exactly known how long Celia's clone survived. Accounts vary from 7 to 10 minutes. Although she didn't last very long, within those minutes, the Pyrenean Ibex was technically unextinct. For the very first and only time in history, an animal was reborn from a subspecies that has completely died out. A testament that the cloning program has the capacity to bring back extinct animals. Restoring a stable number of population in the wild, however, is still far from reality. The Pyrenean Ibex was successfully resurrected, but it was not, by all means, saved. It was brought back from extinction, only for it to become extinct once again.